Hey everybody, my name's Lyndon, and in this video I'm going to do a quick demo of a logo or title intro animation using some basic effects and techniques to make rising water and some rain. So here's what we're going to make. If that sounds interesting, let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is make a new comp, 1920 by 1080, 30 FPS, 200 frames. I'm going to make some text. I'm going to center that. Okay, so now we need some water, so we're going to grab a new solid. Let's call this water level. And we're going to put a gradient ramp effect on it. So the end color is going to be down here, so we're going to make this a deeper blue. And then for the start color at the top, we're going to just make that brighter. Then we're going to just come down here, grab the rectangle tool, and draw out a mask at the bottom. So make sure you give yourself enough room at the sides and the bottom. Then we're going to grab both of these vertices at the top and just pull that down a little bit. That's going to be where the water level starts. And now the alpha is not 100% occupied, so we can grab a stroke effect. And that's going to follow the mask and just put this edge on it. So around 15 is probably good on that. And then for the color, I'm going to sample this bright color up here and just make it a bit brighter. So the next step is to make this kind of wobble, and we're going to do that with a turbulent displacement effect. Alright, so for the amount, let's do about 20, and if we animate the evolution, it's going to make it look like the water is moving. And we're going to do that with an expression, so hold down the Alt key and select the stopwatch for evolution, and then we're going to type in time, asterisk, and then however many degrees you want this to rotate per second. So 360 means one full revolution per second. If we play this forward, you can see that it's going to continuously wobble forever. Okay, so the next thing is we're going to animate the mask going up. So open up the mask control. We can set a mask path at 0 and go forward towards the end here. And then we're going to grab just those top vertices and then pull them up. So we get something like this. And we could ease this in a little bit, so go to the graph editor, you're on the mask path, take this value and ease it in. So it's going to start more slowly, just ease into that motion. Okay, so now we can close this, and because I need this as a mat for the text, I'm going to pre-compose this. So right click, pre-compose, move all attributes into the new composition. It's going to take off the one from there, but you can just leave that as water level comp. Then we're going to duplicate it and move one to the bottom, hit enter, and then call this one background, and then enter again on the top one and call this one matte. So downpour is only going to show up where the water level is. So if we set the track matte to alpha, it's going to disappear wherever the water isn't, and as it rises, it will reveal the text. Something like that. Okay, but with some other things that we would need to do first. So I'm going to take the text element and I'm going to duplicate that. And for this one, we're actually going to right click, do create, create masks from text. Then you can delete the reference that was made, the original text layer. And with this outlines layer, we basically get masks of all the letters. Okay, now because we have the masks, then we can add a stroke effect. So for the stroke, we can do on transparent, turn the masks off. Set all masks to be on, and then for the brush size, we do something like 4. And I want some rain to basically cut through some of this text, and the text will only show up, or this outline of the text will only show up where there's some rain particles. So we're going to grab a new solid, call this rain, and we're looking for an effect called CC rainfall. And right away, we need to turn off composite with original. For the number of drops, we could do something like 1500. And then for the wind, just put it at more of an angle. It'll just look a little bit more interesting. Something like that. Now we need two layers for this. We need one rain that's acting as a mat and another rain layer that's acting simply as visible rain. And because we have two of these, we want to make sure that we pre-compose this. So if we change the settings of one, both the mat and what's visible will change. So right click, pre-compose, let's call it rain comp. And then we need to duplicate this. So the one on the bottom, we're just going to call this one rain comp mat. And on the rain comp, if we just solo the outlines layer, set the track mat to be alpha, is only going to show up, the text is only going to show up where the rain passes through. But in order for that to be a little bit more visible, on the rain comp matte layer, I'm going to grab a fast blur. And we're going to increase this up until we can see quite a bit more of the text, something more like that. And then if we turn the rain back on, it's going to be a little bit too heavy. So if we click T for opacity, we pull that down to something like 20%. And now you can begin to see like an essence of the logo or the title. So it's not fully a reveal, but we can still see a little bit of it. So that's the idea for that. And we can unsolo these. And now we need to change some of the layer orders, because right now the camera is supposed to be right at the waterline and the rain is going in front of this. So really what we want is these three layers at the bottom to actually be at the top. So now it looks like the rain is just stopping when it hits the surface. Okay, so on our rain now, I'm going to go to the rain comp. And I'm going to lock this composition at the top here, double click on the rain comp, and then we have two compositions open, so then drag one composition over to the side, and then we can work inside the rain comp while seeing the results of the main comp. And all I want to do here is change the color of the rain so it's a little bit more blue. And you can increase the opacity quite a bit as well if that's not as clear. But something that's a little bit easier to control is just adding a fill effect. So we can add a fill effect on this, and then we can just change this to whatever color we want, and it just tends to work a little bit better. We can do something like more like blue rain here. That just tends to work a little bit better. Okay, so we can now close this other composition. And now what we need to do is get splashes to hit the surface of the water. And for that, we're gonna take a copy of this water level comp mat, do Control D. We can turn this layer on, and I'm gonna solo it. And this, we're actually gonna call this rain splashes. And we're going to use a particle system called CC Particle Systems 2. And with this particle system, there's an option in Particle to use Source Alpha Inheritance. This means that it's only going to emit particles wherever that mat is. So if we remember that mat, if we disable this, is the water level. And wherever it's transparent, there'll be no particles that are emitting. And then wherever the alpha shows up, then it will emit on the alpha only. So if we turn this back on, we're going to change the physics tab and the producer tab. So the first thing is for animation, let's do fractal explosives. It's going to be a little bit more random. And then for the radius, we're going to pull this out so it's beyond the canvas. And then for the radius Y, we're going to pull this up too, so it's also above the canvas. And we're going to have to reduce the gravity here, so we get particles that can also go further up as well. For the longevity, we're going to do something like maybe 0.2. And then we're going to unsolo this. We're going to take this rain splashes and pull it underneath the outlines layer. So now it looks like the rain, when it hits the water, is actually splashing up. Now we need to add a lot more particles on the birth rate to get this to look better. Something more like this. And then obviously we now need to change the color. So for the birth color, we can just do this blue here. And then for the death color, we could just sample a deeper blue thing, more like this. And then we could add a lot more to the birth rate depending on how many particles you want. And then you could add a little bit more gravity in if you wanted to have this kind of fall a little bit. And you can play around with the longevity as well, something kind of like that, to see what looks right. Now, one thing that we haven't done and we need to do is add motion blur to all these layers. So it's only going to be for layers that really move or transform, but we're going to do it for all of them, so it's easier to do. And that will make all of the particles slightly smaller. So on the rain splashes layer again, we're going to add a fast blur just to soften these up a little bit, make the splashes look a little bit larger. And for the blurriness, just do a blurriness of 1. And then we're going to add a vector blur as well. And now vector blur is going to allow each one of these to be a little bit more random in the shape. So a low value there will give a little bit more randomness to how that looks. And let's go to zoom out there. And there's a few other things that we can do to make this look a little bit better. For the color of the splashes, I'm going to actually brighten up the death color just a little bit, so they show up a little bit longer. Also going to add a curves effect, so we can play with the values there. Okay, so now we're nearly done. This is a few things I want to do. So on the original text down here, on the downpour text layer, I'm going to add a turbulent displace effect again. But this time for the amount, we're just going to do a value of around 5, or maybe we could do 10. And then for the evolution, I'm going to do time multiplied by about 90. So it's always going to just wobble slightly, as if it's in the water. And I'm going to close these layers now. We're nearly done. A few finishing touches. Add an adjustment layer. It's called a CC for color correction. Got to add a curves. And before the curves, I could also add a CC vignette to pull your eye further into the center. So on the curves, I'm actually going to add a little bit to darkness here. I'm going to pull down some of the whites, just a little bit, slightly not as white. And then on the blue channel, add a little bit more blue into the shot. Okay, so there you have it. I hope you found that interesting. Thank you very much for watching and have a good day.